Gospel of St. John, the sixth Amen. Chapter.
Amen.
It's a very long chapter. I'm not going to try to do all of it. Don't get nervous. Amen. But in John, that's in the New Testament, the fourth book. The New Testament scripture, the Gospel of St. John. And we're in the sixth chapter. Verse number 35. Amen. It says, and Jesus said unto them,
yeah.
I am the bread of
yes.
life.
Yes.
He that cometh to me shall never hunger. And he that believeth on me shall never thirst. But I say unto you that ye also have seen me and believe not. All that the Father hath given me shall come to me. And I will in no wise cast out. For I came down from heaven not to do my own will,
all right,
but the will of him that sent me.
All right.
And this is the Father's will which hath sent me, that of all which he hath given me, I should lose nothing, but should raise it up again at the last day. And this is the will of him that sent me, that everyone which seeth the Son and believeth on him may have everlasting life. And I will raise him up at the last day.
Yeah.
Praise the Lord. And if I can skip down to verse number 65. It said, and he said, therefore, said I unto you that no man can come unto me except it were given unto him of my Father. And from that time, many of his disciples went back and walked no more with him. And then said Jesus unto the 12, will you also go away? And then Simon Peter answered him, Lord, to whom shall we go? Thou hast the words of eternal life. And we believe and are sure that thou art that Christ, the Son of the living God. Praise the Lord. I just want to talk about the bread of life. Just want to talk about the bread of life. Jesus dubbed himself as the bread of life. Bread, you know what bread is. That's food or nourishment. In some instances, we even refer to it as a livelihood. Y'all ain't saying that.
Yes,
and when we say, I gotta go make that bread, y'all ain't saying that. We're not saying we gotta go make bread that the pudding
right.
And what we're saying is we gotta make something that will eventually convert into bread. Y'all ain't saying that. When you get hungry, and I tell you something, natural bread, as we know it, is one of the oldest known artificial foods it is. Y'all understand that? You understand that? Bread has been around for a long time. It is sustaining, and when you're hungry, some folks will tell you, you need to just put some kind of bread on it.
All right, all right.
about some things.
Yeah.
But some stuff you just can't live
Amen.
Without.
Amen.
And I don't care who you are, how fine you are, how good looking you are, how healthy you think you are. You got to eat sometimes.
Amen.
You
know,
right. I mean, physically, naturally, you have got. You keep trying to work on your figure all you want, but you're going to eventually have to eat something, else you're going to die.
Amen.
Amen. And I don't care who it is. And not only that, when you deprive yourself of something to eat physically, not only do you just, you don't just get hungry, but some other stuff. I can't even think right if I get I was looking at some furniture the other day, and I told the lady, "Let me, I got to go home and eat something first. I can't run all kind of numbers by me, and I ain't had nothing. I got to put something in my stomach."
Amen.
Because it affects more than just your appetite.
Yeah.
Y'all understand me? I'll tell you another thing about natural bread. When you sometimes you don't have no appetite. But you still need the bread to sustain. You know what I'm saying? See, some folks eat just because they know they got to eat in order to live. And some folks eat till they kill themselves. You know what I'm saying? And some folks just eat because they like to eat.
Amen.
That's right.
But either way, anybody got to eat something.
Yeah.
Now, Jesus in the text, the sixth chapter of John, I like it because a whole lot of stuff was going on.
Yeah.
That gives us some very good life lessons.
Uh-huh.
All right. Jesus had been teaching with his core group of disciples.
Yes.
We often talk about the 12 disciples, but the scripture gives it one time there were 120, another time there were 70.
Yes.
And disciples are just those who have accepted the gospel of Christ.
Amen.
And those who have discipline. It comes from the word discipline. Those who have discipline themselves according to the word of God. See, there are some folk who join the church, they join the choir, they join the usher board, but they're not disciples. In other words, they just came and they still live like they were living all along. Y'all ain't saying they don't have no discipline about themselves. They still do whatever they're big enough to do. But true disciples is following Christ and governing your life according to his life. Y'all understand? Lining up with him. You know when you come to trust in folk and you take a liking to folk and you start hanging around folk, after a while you kept yourself talking like them. Y'all understand? You got to believe on him to the extent that you take a liking to him. That you want to be like him. You want to please him. You want to obey him. And I tell you, almost every Sunday, the book says when a man's ways, his character, his
manner,
would please the Lord, he makes even his enemies to be at peace with him. You understand that? So we're trying to make peace with the enemy and not trying to please God. But if the ways would please God, then God would make your enemies be at peace with you. They don't mean you're trying to satisfy your enemy. I'm trying to make peace with your enemy. Man can't get no satisfaction. The Lord, you what satisfy him today? Don't do nothing for him tomorrow. You know, folk, what used to be good enough for them ain't good enough no more.
Right.
What used to make them happy don't make them happy no more.
Yeah.
My Lord.
God is the same.
Yes.
Oh, yesterday.
Thank you.
Today and forever.
Thank you.
What he didn't like last year, he still likes.
All right.
What he liked last year, he still likes. Y'all understand? God doesn't change. Man changes. And we make the dreadful mistake of trying to satisfy man and disregard God. But the bottom line is you need God. You don't need man.
Amen.
God is the giver of life.
Yes.
Maybe you didn't hear what I said.
Amen.
God is the giver and the sustainer of life. And God wants us to know that we can lean and depend upon him. He wants us to know that not only can he satisfy our natural needs, but he also can satisfy our spiritual needs. In the text, the Bible says that Jesus and his disciples been together for a number of days.
Amen.
The more he tried to get away from the crowd, the larger the crowd became.
Amen. Amen.
The Bible said that Jesus looked in the crowd and asked the disciples, Reggie, where can we get enough money? Reggie, where can we buy bread?
Amen.
For this many people.
Yeah, I know it.
The Bible said he knowing all the time what he was going to do. Y'all answer. And some most questions are all questions that God answered, that Jesus had. They already know the answer. The question is not for their benefit, but the question is for your benefit. The question was for the benefit of the disciples. Jesus wanted them to know that what he was about to do, they could not do, but he could do. And he wants us to know that the stuff that we're trying to do, we cannot do. Somebody said even even 200 penny worth wouldn't be enough to feed this many people.
My Lord.
The Bible says that one of his disciples, Andrew, who was Simon Peter's brother, told Jesus, well, anyway, there was a little boy here that had two little fish and five barley loaves of bread.
Yes, uh-huh.
And he mentioned it. He thought it was worth mentioning.
Yeah.
But the other words, there was some faith involved. Now, knowing that Jesus could do something, he had turned water into wine. Yeah. But he said, that's a little boy with a lunch for himself. But what is that among so many? And sometimes that's what our problem is with God. We can't see how we can make a way, but we all just need to see how God can make a way. That distorts our faith because we know we are limited and we can't do it so much. But God spoke a world into existence. And don't you tell me he can't do whatever he wants. Don't tell me he can't do something with nothing. You and I can't do something with nothing. But God can do whatever God chooses to do.
Amen.
How do you recognize that somebody got something?
Yes.
He just understands that it don't really make no sense in putting it out. So, Jesus simply told him, well, I tell you what you do, make some people sit down.
Yeah.
Organize.
Yeah, man. Let.
He sat down and Jesus took the little boy's lunch.
Yes.
And he blessed it.
Hallelujah.
And I don't believe he said, God is great, God is good.
Amen.
Go ahead. Let us thank him for our food, amen. I don't believe he said it.
Yeah. All right.
My Lord.
But it said, when he had given thanks,
Amen.
He distributed it.
Yes.
And he done drank one boy's lunch.
Yeah.
My God.
And got a distribution line.
Y'all
amen.
Amen.
Yes, he did.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
It didn't say he passed it.
Right.
But he distributed it to the disciples. The disciples to them that were sent down. And likewise, the fish. As much as they would.
My God.
Now, don't mix that as much as they would.
Amen.
Because some folk, you can't do as much as they would with. Y'all ain't saying that. Some folk, they would how much you would. Y'all ain't saying that. All that you can put out, that's how much they. Jesus would have been still passing for some folk. But as much as everybody has enough.
Amen.
To answer Andrew's question, thank you for the suggestion. Thank you for putting on where something was. Y'all ain't saying that. What the folk we work for got. What we worry about what other folk have. And not recognizing that the Bible said, the book said that the silver is mine. The gold is mine. The cattle of a thousand here. Talk about this and the earth is the Lord. The fullness that of the world and 3 to 12. What that says to me is that if it says the earth is the Lord.
Yeah.
The fullness that the world and they that dwell therein. Now that says to me that it doesn't really matter, just like with the boys, it doesn't matter whose hand is here right now. Y'all ain't got to say it. It doesn't matter who's in possession of it. If God's desire for you to have it, you're going to have it. I don't care because that's the last one they made. I don't care because they know they're all over the other. God wants you to have. Is to please him.
Amen.
To find favor with him.
Yeah, Lord.
To make him want to do something for you.
Yes.
You know, folks keep talking about favor ain't fair. Favor is fair. If you find favor with God, y'all ain't saying that. If the book says that a man's ways will please the Lord, that's favor. The book says, if you be willing and obedient, you can eat the good of the land. That's favor and it is fair. Jesus distributed the fishes and the bread.
Amen.
And I ain't going to try to explain it or stretch the story.
Yeah.
But the Bible said when they were filled, that he said to the disciples, gather up the fragments. Other words, they had leftovers.
Oh, yeah. Amen. Yeah. Yeah.
And the Bible said that this crowd was of 5,000 men.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's not counting their women and their children. Yeah. But it was a minimum of 5,000. And chances are that number could have been at least double or more when you in factored in that.
Amen.
We still pity patting around with God. Tell the Lord, just let me get my life healed this month. Like it ain't gonna come again next month. We pity patting with God. Trying to beg and hustle and swim with God. Y'all ain't saying that. Instead of just having a relationship, a healthy relationship with God, but God will take full responsibility for you.
Yes, he will. Glory.
Reason why he was interested in feeding these disciples. Reason why he kept all of their problems was because they followed him.
Yeah.
And if you follow and obey him and trust him, he'll do the same thing for you.
Yes, he will. Yeah. All right. All right.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, amen. Hallelujah.
He stopped the storm on their behalf.
Amen.
Because they were in the ship with him.
Yeah.
I remember when the Bible says somebody asked Peter, don't go, Lord, pay taxes.
All right, now.
And Peter said, yeah, we pay taxes. You know, just running off flat off the mouth. Yeah, we pay taxes. Jesus told him, you shouldn't have never said that, but since you don't open your big mouth, go out there to the water and grab a fish. And the first fish you get, open up his mouth and get the mouth out of the mouth. I told you something. Peter was a fisherman by trade.
Amen.
And I'm sure he had caught a many fish.
All right.
I don't know if he started checking their mouths after that. You know what I'm saying?
All right.
But I'm sure he had never gotten money out of a fish's mouth before that. That's Jesus when the hell telling him to look at that. Y'all ain't saying that. See, his job was catching fish, selling fish, and then making money and paying tax. But what Jesus says, get all of them stuff. Just go get the fish and bring it in his mouth and get the money and say, we would be stealing some stuff that we would just follow and trust it all. I don't know if it's a good time to talk about it, but they used to have a song out of back in 77 saying, if it don't fit, don't force it. We're trying to make some stuff happen. The Bible said when they saw this miracle,
yeah.
And some miracles can make you believe. But other miracles, you know, in other words, if you saw God heal somebody, that can make you believe in God, but it won't necessarily make you follow him. Y'all ain't saying that. But see, this miracle, everybody benefited from it. Y'all ain't saying that. Everybody got fooled off of this miracle. So a lot of people who wouldn't have followed him if he had cured somebody started following him because he was able to stretch that bread. Y'all ain't saying that. Most of us, if we knew a way to stretch bread, y'all gonna get this. If we knew a better way to stretch bread, if we knew how to make our check last from this month to next month, or from this month to next year, y'all ain't saying that. You gotta believe we be clinging to that.
Amen. Amen.
So a lot of them who wouldn't have been following him started following him after that meeting.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying.
Awesome.
I'm sure many started following him after he turned the water into wine. Some of y'all still looking for him over there. But he said many of them started following him. And I want to tell you something. We have to take you at face value, and we have to try to figure you out. And if we don't have no spirit of discernment, you can tell us anything. But Jesus already knows your heart. The Bible said that he sit high, he looked down low. In fact, it said he even knew our thoughts from afar. So the thing that you're thinking, he knew it before you even thought it. Y'all ain't saying that. He knows already what's in your mind and in your heart. And that's why I be trying to figure out folk hiding from little me and big old God looking right at you.
Yeah.
How big a house
Amen.
He's allowed them to get.
Amen.
What kind of job he's allowed them to get. What kind of career he allowed them to have. How happy they are with material things.
Amen.
Hard to get folk to testify. I reckon that's why. And I used to always get upset when in the old school church they would tell the people, no matter what, when you testify, make sure you thank God for fire and the Holy Ghost. Now, listen, I'm going to tell you something. I thought that was beautiful because I always felt like if you had the Holy Ghost, you wouldn't have to tell nobody your head. Y'all ain't saying. But now I may receive, maybe what they were saying was make sure you're grateful for that upon everything else. Follow me for the bread.
Right.
And then he told him, labor not for meat that perish.
Amen.
But for the meat that endure.
Amen.
To everlasting life.
Yes.
In Proverbs it says, labor not to be rich. Cease from your own wisdom. Because sometimes when you value yourself based on stuff and things.
Yes.
If stuff and things
come on,
disappear.
Amen.
Then your value ain't nothing. Yes. Y'all ain't saying that. Yes. If stuff and things is what make you, then when you lose your stuff and things, y'all ain't saying that. Then that means you're nobody.
Yes.
And that's why rich folks are wind up killing themselves when they go broke. And y'all ain't saying that. But if you ever understand that money don't make you, but you make money, y'all better get this. We all understand that you got to have money, but even if you ain't got money, if you got Jesus, y'all ain't saying that. He made 5,000 broke, hoping folk at the same time.
Amen.
Amen.
Don't
be working for the meat that perish. Otherwise, some of us, it's way more important to go to work than it is to come to church.
Yeah.
And I know what the devil told you to tell me. Church don't pay my bills. And I know when you just look at it directly, it don't. But in church, I was in church when I read where it said, it is him that give you power to obtain wealth. Y'all understand that? I was in church when I read that every good and perfect gift comes from above. I was in church when I heard that everything that was ever made, God made. Every good and perfect gift come from above. All I'm saying is, I don't care how, if you made a lot of money, and all you can do is say you made a lot of money, and you don't have it right now, that all yourself ought to tell you that money ain't everything.
Amen. Amen.
What's up?
Sometimes I'm just ashamed when I think about how much money I got here. Y'all ain't saying that. To a whole bunch of so-called friends.
Yes.
But don't you mess around and let the money run out.
All right. Yeah.
You'll finally learn what some folk voice message said.
Verse
it now. You know, if you got money, you may never hear the answering machine. Yeah. They're going to pick up every time you call. Y'all ain't saying that. You know, if you're throwing money out. Jesus said, you don't be laboring for just me.
Amen. Yes.
Some of us, the more we work, the less we have.
Yeah. Amen. All right.
And I tell you something, when you put something before God,
amen.
I don't care what it is.
That's right.
You ought to just give God what he do.
Yeah. All right.
Amen.
Amen.
Because if you give God what God is due, God is going to take care of you because God honors his word. But what you're trying to do is get God to honor how you want. You're trying to get God to work how you want him to work. And God already explained how he works. You understand? He said, seek first the kingdom of heaven and its righteousness. And whatever you need will be added to you. He didn't say seek stuff and things and then if you find the kingdom along the way, it'll work.
Spiritual thing.
mature enough.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
And y'all think even rich folk know better than to start off a 2-year-old with $1,000 a week of
that. Right.
Amen.
you could give it to him, but it's gonna be squandering and wasting.
Yeah.
Probably just throw it away.
Amen.
I remember when I was growing up, we had an aunt that lived in Birmingham. She was a nurse, and we thought they were rich. And when we would go to visit them, our other cousins would try to beat us getting there. Because their mama gave them all kind of money, and they didn't like change. You understand that? Like they didn't like coins.
Right.
And I ain't talking about last year. I'm not 30. I'm not 20 and nothing no more. And when money was, with coins, you could still get some stuff.
Yeah.
And when we would get to their house, you just straightway hit the floor as soon as you got there. There'd be quarters all under the rug. We all under the bed, and everyone looking for their money.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen. And somebody told me later on that they didn't like change. I didn't know that's why the money would be down there. I thought they just like to see us make a fool out of ourselves. But just like they were with change, that's how immature folk is with money. Y'all ain't saying that. And some of us are 40 and 50 and 60, and we still can't do no better with money than a 2-year-old. And if God just wants to come on, just make us rich and give us everything we needed, we still would be with that.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. If you give us enough of material things,
yes,
to say to us there's more where that came from.
Yes.
And I'm just gonna give you enough to let you know that I'm interested. You know how we do. To give you enough to let you know I'm interested in you. You know how y'all measure stuff. You go out and Jim can't buy you a drink. You ain't trying to get him your number. Y'all, well, that's how they used to do. I don't know. You know, if he can cruise a minute and buy you a drink, you already know how to get him your
number. Amen. Amen.
That wasn't the drink. Other than trying to get you drunk and take advantage of me, but the drink was so that you wouldn't know that I ain't tired.
Right.
So after that, you get the drink and then you test it out. Well, I'm gonna see. You try them out with something else.
All right.
You know what I'm talking about.
All right.
Yes. Then after a while, you know that they gonna do a little something. Then after a while, you just build a relationship off of that.
Yeah.
Maybe you like them, maybe you don't, but you like what they're doing.
Some of
that's how we are with God, and this is what Jesus said.
Yeah.
They don't like me, they just like what I'm doing. They just like the idea that I feed them. They just like the idea that I'm blessing them with material things. But God has far more for us than that. More of that material thing. Because if God doesn't adjust your heart, it doesn't matter what kind of material things you have, you'll never be satisfied. Y'all ain't saying that. It is rich for who commit suicide because they can't find no satisfaction. Designed us.
Oh yes.
With a place for him in our hearts.
Amen.
Yes.
And if you never allow him to come into that place,
you'll
never be whole.
Amen. You know what I mean?
He designed us by design.
Yeah.
With a place in our heart.
Amen.
For him.
Amen.
Right.
And if you'll never allow him to get in that place, you'll never have satisfaction. Folk like that. They be talking about something. How many good men they have had? How many good jobs they have had? How many good women they have had? And still they're never satisfied. Can't get along with nobody. All that fourth and fifth marriage. By the way, who else still telling you how to do?
Amen.
Amen.
My Lord.
But he said, the will is to believe on him that sent me. We got to believe enough to trust him. And this trust has to be without solution. The more you trust him, the more he'll do for you. He don't want you relying on everybody else and using him as an afterthought. Y'all understand that? Those of us that drive cars, we don't ever check to see if the spare tire got air in it. Y'all understand? Even if we get on the highway, we as long as them four on there ain't flat, we ride. And that's all we do with God. We check, we ride on what we got. We ride the way we know how to ride it. We don't even check to see if we still got it. Y'all ain't saying that. We don't even check to see if he's going to be there. We just keep on talking about your present, health, and time and come. He is the folk who got it. So, they told him, show up, listen to this. These fools and told him, show us a sign, man. So we can believe.
My Lord.
He just took two fish.
Yes, he did.
And five loaves of bread. And fed thousands of folks. And they wanted a sign. He took clear water. And turned it into wine. And they still wanted to see the sign. The sign is he doing stuff that can't none of y'all do. It'd have been something else if after he turned, took the two kids and five loaves, if somebody else had to say, oh, something else if he was doing stuff that we can do outside. But God will bless you in a way where you have to say nobody but God. Why would you need a fucking sign? This handicap, because when man can't do something, we equate that to meaning that God can't do it. Because what the doctor really should have said was, we as doctors don't know how to do this, but God can do it if he wants. And perhaps that's what they're saying, but the devil causes us to read in a whole nother way. Y'all ain't saying that. And when they start saying, the only people we ever saw with this never got healed. The only people, we don't have no cure for this. You don't have a cure for it, but God is a cure. God can speak it. God can cause it to go through. Thing is, it's based on your faith. My faith ain't gonna move your situation. Your faith has to move your situation. And the Bible says faith comes by hearing the word of God. And I don't care who tell you, or you can make it if you work hard. I know some folk who work way harder than you. The slaves work hard. You can have anything you want. You just got to apply yourself. You can be anything you want. You just got to apply yourself. Quit lying. I don't care how much application you put on. I don't care how much you apply yourself. Outside of God, you are nothing.
Amen.
And now with God, I can, Paul says, that I can do all things through Christ Jesus that strengthens me. So it is the will of the Lord that I believe and trust and obey him. They not only told him to show us a sign, they made another argument. They said, our fathers ate manna in the wilderness. Yeah, you know, in other words, the Jews thought Moses was everything. Uh-huh. And so what they were saying was when our fathers was in the wilderness, Moses gave them bread from heaven.
Yeah. Yeah.
You ain't did nothing.
My Lord. My Lord. My Lord.
Jesus said, what Moses gave them wasn't the true bread.
Yeah,
amen.
Uh-huh.
Hallelujah. My Lord, amen.
He said, but my Father want to give you the true bread from heaven.
Yeah.
Amen.
The bread of God is it which come down from heaven.
Amen.
And gives life to the world.
Yes.
So in other words, what he's saying is that when Moses gave them bread, a manna, from heaven.
Uh-huh.
What he's saying is that simply met their physical need.
Amen.
That just made them not starve to death.
Right. Yeah. Right.
But it did not give them any right to heaven. Yeah. It did not give them any right to eternal life.
Yeah.
It just prevented them from starving at that moment. It just relieved the crisis. And some of us are just like that. All we want is just some relief.
Yeah.
We don't even want deliverance. We just want relief. Distinct difference in deliverance and relief.
Amen.
Sometimes when the man going upside your head, maybe the other way around, maybe the woman going upside your head, but when you call the police, you don't want deliverance, you just want relief.
Yeah.
I know that because when the police put them handcuffs on and take them to jail, now you want to fight the police.
Yeah.
You call the police because somebody was going upside your head. The police take them to jail and now you going down there with the bail. You just wanted some relief. You just wanted the knots to get well before you hit you again. That's all. We don't want deliverance from the devil. We just want relief from what the devil is causing, the havoc he's causing in our life. We just want to ease up some. Most of us just done got so, we deal with the devil so, and we done got so accustomed to dealing with it until we don't need him to be rid of. We don't need to be rid of. We just want to ease up some. I still want to get drunk. I just don't want to have to have my head in the toilet all night.
All right. Yeah.
Jesus said, well, let me get to them. Your father did eat manna in the wilderness.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
And all of them did.
Amen.
They still died.
Yeah.
Amen.
But he said, God wants to give you the bread.
Glory. My Lord.
That if you eat this bread, you'll never die.
Thank you.
Not only that, if you eat this bread, you'll never be hungry again.
Yeah.
In other words, he wants to satisfy your spiritual need.
Yeah.
You don't just want to satisfy your physical need,
amen,
but he wants to satisfy your spiritual need.
Yeah.
Because if your spiritual needs are met, you will not have to worry about your physical needs. Y'all ain't saying that. If you get God in your heart, you don't have to worry about what's going on around you. You don't have to fix stuff because you got the fixer right there with you. You don't have to worry about trouble and problems because you got a problem solving right there with you. Jump your devil in your heart. What we're trying to do, we're trying to fake a relationship. So we can get what we want.
Yeah.
Right.
You know the game that women been playing for years. Y'all ain't saying. I ain't gonna marry you because I want to be able to do how I want to do.
Uh-huh.
I want to be able to say, you don't see no ring on this thing. That's all right, baby, because the ring ain't on your finger, but he might come and he might not come. Y'all ain't saying that. But if you put the ring on your finger, he got to come. He can either come on his own or it's a way to make him come. Y'all ain't saying that. what we're saying to God is, I take whatever he gives me, but I'm not going to commit myself to him. I want to be able to fight with this. I want to be able to go over there. I want to be able to act like this and be grown. Y'all ain't saying that. I want to be my own individual. I want to be wild, loose, and single, and free. Y'all ain't saying that. But yet want the benefits of a wife, want the benefit of a husband. We want God to come when we call him. We want God to be available for us at all times. And yet we're never available for God. Don't you think I made that up? What's important to me ain't important to you. What's important to you ain't gonna be important to me. Don't you think I just thought that up? Don't you think the Bible said, be not deceived. God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man says, that shall he also reap. And if you want full-time benefits from God, you gotta be a full-time child of God.
Yes.
You didn't want God to be a dewdrop by. And you didn't want God to be a sugar daddy. Even with sugar daddy, sometimes the sugar wear out.
Right.
And you ain't got nothing but a daddy. Y'all ain't saying that. These are the true bread.
Yes.
Which came down from heaven.
Lord,
yeah. And if you come to me, you'll never hunger.
Thank you, God.
If you lean on me, you'll never thirst.
Amen.
I like that about God.
Yes.
Because if you ever believe what he's saying, you gotta believe him when you're thinking, when you're sleeping, when you're woke. Y'all ain't saying that. So then Jesus just kept on talking about being the bread.
Yeah.
Right.
And the more he talked, the more the people began to fall off.
Amen.
And then he told them, except you eat my flesh and drink my blood.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. You can't be saved. And he said, if you eat him, you live by him.
Yes, sir.
And the Bible says, they begin to reason, what kind of foolishness is this?
Yeah.
That this man said we got to eat his blood, eat his flesh, and drink his blood. They had strict commandments from Moses to never drink or touch blood.
Amen.
Now this man says, except you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life in you. And then Jesus said after they began to murmur, do this offend you?
Yeah.
If this offend you, what's going to happen when you see the Son of Man go up in the cloud? And he said it's the spirit that quickened them, but the flesh don't profit nothing. No matter how well you eat, no matter what kind of diet you're on, no matter how much you have of materialistic things, if you don't have the Spirit of God, then you don't have nothing. When you come down to die, he said it's the Spirit of God that will raise you. He said the same Spirit that raised Christ from the dead has to quicken this body of ours. I thank God for the Spirit of life. I thank God for the bread of life. What he said here is what he told Moses. I am that I am. Whatever you need, if you got God, you got all you need. still coming up short. Quit going the long way and still coming up short. But see Jesus, you'll feel better about everything else. See Jesus, and for who you thought was all bad. And you let God change your heart. You'll find out some of them folks that have issues. You just had issues. Let me tell you what I'm saying. If you're looking out the window, and the window dead on the inside, what you see on the outside ain't gonna look like it really is. But if you clean the window and then look outside, you'll find stuff look better than you thought it did. Some of us gotta clean our hearts, gotta let God clean us up, and everybody gonna have problems like we think they all got problems. We'll find out it wasn't them, but it was us, and we can tell along. Wash me, clean me. Young boys and girls, how to use the restroom. They got new stuff. And the toilets they got now, y'all ain't saying no. You don't have to flush them.
All right.
But the mess ain't gonna go nowhere till you walk away from it. Y'all ain't saying no. You gotta turn around and move. That's all I like to hear. Some of us ought to be trying to hear. You talking to folk got mess all the time. That foolishness ain't gonna cause me to miss Jesus. I'm not gonna stand there looking at the mess. I'm not gonna try to figure out how it works. But I know when you walk away from it, you don't have to worry about it no more. When you walk away. Got these things they call waste baskets. I'm through. You can go buy a waste basket. Brand new out of Walmart. And you can wipe it out with some gentle soap and warm water. Dry it out real good and you can keep your sugar in it.
All right.
You can put flour in it. Rice and beans. But if you ever put garbage in it, you know it ain't fit for your sugar. It ain't fit for your rice and for your beans. Y'all ain't saying that. And I ain't gonna let nobody put no garbage inside of me. I ain't let nobody put no mess inside of me. Trying to make it work on your own.
Yeah.
Have not given God the chance to prove himself. You trying to play him off of some stuff he did last year.
Yeah.
you're trying to trick